Hello and welcome to the live stream of the IndyCar 250 right here at SimRace TV. We've had a quite exciting qualification right now, and the starting grid looks like this. Hugo Vinen on first with a time of 36.86. Ronnie Krampus on second with a time of 36.87. P. Kubit third with a 36.88. Martin Kapal, fourth with a 36.88. Jala Dohnalik, fifth with a 36.89. Conradi from South Africa on sixth with a 36.89. Ramon Blauer from seventh with a 36.90. Remco Major on eighth with a 36.90 as well. Brak Sattar on 9th with a 36.91. Sorry for the mess up there. Patrick Hall on 10th with a 36.92. Oh, can't read that. Ostoy on 11th with a 36.92. Maciejowski on 12th with a 36.96. Holmberg on 13th with a 36.97. Matonis on 14th with a 36.97. Clear on 15th with a 36.97. And Sarah on 16th with a 36.97. Andrew on 17th with a 39. Karani on 18th with a 36.99. Sebastian Wojtkowiak on 19th with a 37 flat. Behrens on 20th with a 37.01. Twickle, or however you say that, on 21 with a 37.1. On 22nd with a 37.02. Rodriguez on 23rd with a 37.04. Agesh on 24th with a 37.10. Tirren on 25th with a 37.13. Last but not least, Silva with a 37.56. I hope I covered the whole field with that. As there's some discussion pre-race. The race will last Hey, we are counting down to the start. A few minutes to go, I guess now. Maybe a few seconds. As I have understood from the razor action that I'm having some lag with my commentary, but I hope that's not going to disturb the whole broadcast, so we're looking forward to a really exciting race from Oval, F08. Let's do this, guys. So really seconds now from going on to the warm-up laps. As we have Sami Huivonen, yes, from first BFA on pole. Ronnie Krumplers from Race Green Autosport on second. And Kubit from, let me search his team, that is none. He's from Poland, but he doesn't have a team. He's on third. Oh, I have some lag there from the leader. As the leader is timing out people, oh no, he's not. And he's lagging like a maniac. This could cause really big trouble at the start because the leader is lagging for me. So okay, so let's take a realistic look at who is entitled to maybe in the chance to win the race. What are the favorites? I think one of my personal favorites is Mr. Ramon Blauer from the Netherlands, from SPDO Racing. I guess he has a fair chance at winning because if you look back at his history on F08 races on Oval, he's done quite well. And mainly in general, he's a pretty good driver in F08, so it's my personal favorite. And also Patrick Hall from Canada. He's also quite a good driver on Oval, so maybe Ronnie Krumpus is going to pull some bunny out of his head and share prizes. Maybe Remco Major from Last Light Motorsports. He has been showing quite some good driving on Oval before. So as I'm not entirely sure how many pace laps we'll have, but I guess we'll soon go underway. as the fastest lap by Kay Jagna is a 1:02.35 as we're still in the base laps. I hope I'm not going to see too many safety cars during this event, because it always takes the action out of the close-packed racing on oval if you get a safety car, but of course it also brings back the close-pack. But what do you, would you rather have a mostly clean race or an action-packed race but with many accidents? I would choose actually for the last one. Okay guys, one lap to gain and F clear just timed out. Number 26 from the Czech Republic. Philip Clear. As the field is double filing, going towards the second last corner now. This can be something really exciting, this race. So let's make it something, guys. Okay, coming up to the last corner before the green. Who will win this 135 lap race? So about getting ready for the green. And yes. Andrea Racing, green. Oh, it looked like an accident, but it was some kind of lag, I guess. Let's see who's marching up the field now. Really big fight going on in the front there. Martin Kapal right next to Ronnie Krompus, who now brushes the wall. Oh, and there has been a big crash in the field, which I've missed. Jagna has crashed. Gallagher has crashed. Laszlo has crashed. And Silva is really driving a very damaged car in the back. As race direction sees, this is no real danger on track yet. Thomas Crony now sets the fastest lap time. A really action-packed field as Jada Dohnalik is challenging for the lead with Remco Major. And also Roman Blauw is going to mix himself into it. A really action-packed already this race. And Huivonen now overtakes on the inside, and now it's Ramon Blauw and Remco Major battling for slipstream. Oh my god, this is really tense racing. Blauw on the inside now, and he's making maybe a gap between him and Remco Major. Wow. Jada Dohnalik and Ramon Blauw side by side. Dohnalik now trying to make the move for the lead, but Remco Major not leaving, and Martin Kapal is coming from the inside of Remco Major. Oh, there comes Kapal, a bit of bump drafting with Jada Dohnalik. That's not the thing to do, I guess, with these cars with a bit of lag. Oh, Remco Major nearly lost it there. As we feel, because there's more action coming. Blauw off nearly making a touché with Huivonen there, who is now going back to the lead in the slipstream battle. There comes Ramon Blauw off again. Remco Major right behind, and also Dohnalik trying to catch the slipstream. It seems that Kapal and Ronnie Krompus have lost the chain to the lead group now, but they're coming back together with Thomas Karani. As the fastest lap right now is by Sarah Franco. in 37.08, as the first pit stops have been made and are being made. For example, Kubit, Ostoy, Gallagher, and also Jagna makes a pit stop. And Remco Majoor and Roman Blauwhoff, Huivonen and Dohnalik are battling still for the lead. We're already 6 laps into the race. This group gets shorter or bigger? We will know. Remco Majoor nearly to make in a touche with Dohnalik and Blauwhoff there. Huivonen now takes the inside. And again, Remco Majoor and Dohnalik close. This is really intense racing and I love it. Whoa, he even make a dangerous move there to the left, but he takes the inside and he takes the lead again. This is brilliant racing in the IndyCar 250 there. As Ramon Blauwhoff now into the lead again. Oh! Dohnalik nearly crashing now with Remco Majoor, it seemed. And I have to take a short break, be right back. As Remco Majoor and Huivonen and also Blauwhoff and also still Dohnalik. Oh, the big crash! A big crash between Majoor and Dohnalik. Oh my word! And Majoor actually reaches the pit lane before, but Dohnalik has spun further. What a terrific incident! Let's see where Dohnalik has ended up. He's with quite much damage on the outside of Vangelov. Oh, they near collide, but he now needs to go to the pits, I guess, with this damage, but he doesn't. He doesn't have the chance to. He's now off. Oh, big crash! Jesus. Again, Dohnalik into a crash, but it was not his fault. He was on the bloody outside. Dohnalik still driving after a second crash, and I really guess he should pit now because no, he doesn't have too much damage. He's dropped back all the way to 16th right now. Oh, and another crash there happening in the back. Kubit just crashed in the last corner. Whoa, mixing himself right into the lead group. Jesus Christ. Yellow flag. Pit close, do not overtake. Guess we're going to have a safety car now. No, just a yellow flag, okay. That was very unfortunate. Quite some crashes now in a few minutes. That was, yeah. Safety car deployed. Let's make a look through the field. We have Huivonen leading now, Roman Blauwhoff in second, Martin Tepal in third, Thomas Kerenny somehow in 4th, Ronnie Crumpers in 5th, M. Braxator in 6th, F. Serra in 7th, Conradi in 8th, Holmberg in 9th, M. Behrens in 10th, Rodriguez in 11th, T. Ren in 18th, sorry, in 12th, 13th we have Maciejowski or something. Schoblom is in 14th, and 15th is Dohnalik, if it seems, no, still a damaged car. And 16th is Silva. No, Silva's on the lap. And 16th is Wojciech. Damn it, I can't say these names. And 17th is Laszlo, Yuri Laszlo. And 18th is now overtaking the lead group. And the pack is Remco Major. 19th on, I think I lap down actually, is Angelov. And 20th, now also overtaking the field, is Silva. And 21st is Ostoy, and I don't know if he's going to overtake the lead group, but and 22nd is Kubit, with quite some damage on his back. And 13th is... sorry, and 23rd, I'm messing up, is Gallagher. And 24th, after a rejoin, is Ragesh. And the field closer is Mr. Kia. He is in 25th. As it seems that the pits is open right now. Yes, indeed, pit lane open. Some drivers are making their first pit stops. As now the 69 is leading the race, S. Huivinen, I don't know how to pronounce that, and 64, the number 64 is in second, Martin Kapal, number 52, Thomas Kerenny is in third, number 96, Ronnie Crumpus is in fourth, and the fifth is number 74, Braxator. sorry for the interruption there, as I missed quite a bit, I guess, because we're now already in a double field, because we're going to green in the next lap. As the safety car has left the field and we're about to go on the road again. As we're going green in. Now we're back racing! A quite bad start from number 69, Huivinen, as he's already got a few cars next to him. Kapal on the outside, number 64 on the outside. Well, now he's on the inside, and Karenny is now on the outside, and Kapal goes to the lead. As number 74, Braxator, is trying to get closer to the lead group. Oh, big crash! Big crash! Number 50, and whoa! Big crash, many cars involved. There's Holmberg and some others, Jesus Christ. As we didn't even do one lap green again. As Gallagher is standing still at the pit entry because he's waiting for the pits open, but it's now open. As he is waiting, whilst it says pit is open. As I just got a confirmation, it was actually number 50 Holmberg and the number 01 Serra that collided. Got this because I'm liking like that looking. Yes, in collision. Oh my god. Stupid, what are you doing? They are saying that Angelov was overtaking some people. And there's some quite kind of chaos right now in the server. as it's really hard for me to commentate at this moment because okay, and we're already going to double file positions indeed, as there's one lap to the green again. Let's hope this time no big accidents. As for now, we have Huovinen again on first, Capel on second, Baksato on third, Karani on fourth, Behrens on 5th and Remco Major on 6th. As we're going through the last corner now, again a few seconds to the green. As we're racing! Good start from Karani, it seems. Oh, big crash again! Was it? Oh no, the whole field! Jesus! Come back, Marcus, and Sky is Conradi, a South African guy. Yellow flag, safety car, do not overtake. As I don't know what Sarah is doing right now, he's overtaking a lot of people. As I have to take a short break because there's some trouble here where I live, so I'll be right back. As I'm back for a few seconds, as there seems to be another safety car, and we've lost quite some drivers, it seems. Oh no, they're in. Oh, there seems to have been a huge crash. And he's got it on TV, but sadly without my commentary. sorry for the interruption. I had some problems. We seem to have quite some good clean moments right now. As the number 69 still in the lead after starting from pole. Now battling with the number 64, Martin Cabal. As during my break. But number 52 Cranny is still driving in third position. And 69 Ronnie Trumpet is driving. That's number 96, sorry, and 58 already battling for a position that might be good for the cameras. As Blauhoff now catches the slipstream of the number 3, of the third guy, Thomas Karani, 52. And they're battling for this position now, for third position, with three cars, three wide! This battle is still going on now. Oh, and a car was standing there on the inside of the field that seemed like Angelov indeed. Sorry for another interruption, I was looking at some data. So yeah, it's Martin Cabal still in the lead together with number 69 Huivinen. And they're approaching a back marker there. And there comes number 69 again on the inside of Cabal. Cabal directly. Oh, Cabal set the fastest lap time of 36.70. That's a nice thing. And so now approaching the back of Conradi. And number 69 really taking a bet there by going so fast out of that slipstream. But Conradi nicely moves out of the way, that's really well done, mate. And 96 Ronnie Trumpus are still battling for third position. basically the battle for the lead between and the battle for third between Krampus and Blauwolf are actually the only real fights that are going on right now. I mean, they have a cameraman, we might have a look. Well, battling maybe right. There's a Rodriguez and Braxator. Let's have a look at a new battle, maybe. Sorry. Then as for the lead, still the battle between number 69. This is really a nice slipstream battle all the time. But it would actually be nice if some other cars got involved. It's also be and there goes Ramon Blauw for the inside, easily going to stick it, and of course Ronnie Crump was directly in the slipstream again. Car 74 with huge damage down on the pit entry. Jesus. That's not so nice there. As I can imagine that happened to the car he was battling with, which was, I believe, Rodriguez, car number 04. They might have had a big collision there. sorry for another interruption. I'm really sorry. You're still seeing a really nice fight between Martin Kapal and Huivinen for the lead. Welcome, Jarre Dohnányk.
Hello! And also hello to all who are watching this stream with this amazing race.
Yeah, tell us what happened.
You know, this race was only 35 laps long for me, but it was very exciting. Like, well, it was great. I was fifth, I guess. And the start of the race was great, as you could have seen. I was in a leading group and then I got a crash with Mr. Major. I don't know whose fault was it, but anyway, I was the unluckiest man when the server was lagging. You surely noticed that there was a lot of crashes, and my first crash was very, very awesome because I flew out of the track, and yes, I was under the track and asking the Mr. Collins if I can rejoin. He said yes, so I was really happy because I was one lap down, and the next caution was also very exciting for me. I've rolled.
But from the racing that I've seen from you today, it was really clean and I've really enjoyed it, but it's really unfortunate that you couldn't make it to the finish, mate. But well done on what you have let us see.
Oh yes, this race is really great. There are only cautions when there's a big crash. Maybe it's not fair for some drivers, but if the caution would be out for all crashes, what happened during the race, we would be under the yellow all time.
Yes, indeed. Just a few moments ago, I think it was car number 74, Baxator or whoever it was, he really had a big crash with Rodriguez, and he wasn't really on the track, but next on the inner field, and he wasn't causing too much damage. He would have called a yellow flag for that, and he could have been doing all the race on the yellow, maybe. So
yeah, it's a NASCAR style, well, where the yellow flag is not out for all crashes, so we can watch an interesting race.
Indeed. As you now of course see that the battle for the lead is still going on between your good mate Martin Kapal and number 69.
Yes, Martin is doing a great job. Unfortunately, my second friend Thomas Koreni, R52, was drafting with him, but during the caution he was spun by another car and he got some damage. He decided to do not repair it, and he was trying to go with it, and he was in a lead. Where is he now? Around 10th position? I don't know.
I think 7th or so.
Yes, his car is very, very damaged, and he's slipped with steering, with handling.
Well, yeah, I would like to thank you for this moment with us, and I wish you all the good luck for the rest of the year.
Thank you, and have good fun with this race.
Thank you very much. See ya.
See ya.
As I've just been checking around, there's just 8 cars left in the lead lap. And to close that lead lap is at this moment Remco Major. He's soon about to be overtaken by the leaders, and I hope he goes out of the way cleanly.
Thank you.
This is unfortunately the end of the commentating on the stream, because I really have something important to do, so I'm really sorry if you will have to leave you with the racing sounds.
Hello! I'm now your commentator for the rest of the stream. Hopefully we won't have silence. I'm not the best commentator, but I will try my best. Yeah, we are still under the yellow flag at the moment. That was caused by a sideways car on the front stretch. Race control thought that it would be safer to pull the safety car out than to let people pile into him, so I stand by with what Cameron Crowe, the race director, does, and I would have called that as well. It could have turned into a very bad incident, which we've seen many times in Live for Speed. Sometimes mixed with lag, and it can ruin people's races. So, we're still in the caution here, the pits are still closed. We're just waiting for car to catch up and get in the right order, then the pits will open, and after that we should be green racing again. The pits are now open, you can enter the pit lane to fix the vehicles or change tyres or whatever they need. So I think that caution was caused by Roman Blow-Off, who was the sideways car on the front stretch. He is car number 58, that's what I heard, but I'm not 100% sure on that, to be honest. He is currently in 4th position. Can obviously track all the standings at tracker.ident-racing.net /realisticnascar, and all the qualifying results are not correct on that page, so don't go by them. We're going to have 45 laps remaining, but Lily have 45 laps remaining. Now going down, obviously going down to 44 laps. That's about 132 kilometers, and we are 1 to green. We're going green this time by. Everyone is assuming double file, so we can continue racing. Did go will pull up to the end of this lap. I would just like to say thank you for joining us live. If you're watching it live, if you're watching this on YouTube later, thank you for viewing. Thank you for viewing on demand video. We will be having this stream. The recording of this stream will be on YouTube later, and the link will be posted in the Live for Speed forum. We're about to go green flag now. Waiting for race control to give the green flag. And there they green flag, we're racing again. And everyone seems to get a clean start. There's quite a few three wide drivers, especially towards the middle of the pack. Oh, and we've got a track. We've got a few cars turned around in turn two. Number 45 is in the wall as well as 31. Both cars have turned around and continued. Quite a lot of damage to number 45, which is Garrett Conrad. Very, very. Pronounced Eng Young. So he's in the war, but he continues. Alright, it looks like the. No. Everyone's still jockeying for position at the minute. We have 32 laps remaining in the line now. Obviously. Countdown at the top of your screen as well. At the front of the pack, we have four cars. I think it's four cars. We count one, two, three. I would say five cars in the battle now. And five car drifting doesn't usually work because there's not much space on the track, but it's actually gone down to four now, shall we? Four cars here. It's all about the rhythm on this track. If you can't get into a good draft with someone or some people, it can be quite hard to keep up and keep it going. That's good execution of the draft at the front of the pack. Everyone seems to be running nicely now. There's quite a few battles going on around the track. Oh, we have a car turned around. That's number 29. Jeff Silver. He hit pit lane with a lot of damage there. Right, he didn't get collected by anyone else. Back up, back to the front, the battle continues with Martin Capel, leading. But the draft changes it all, and I'm not going to keep changing who's the leader, because it will change every 2 seconds. So the number 81... Ooh! No, sorry, the number 81 of... Depot is asking virtual permission, which is permission to talk, basically, if you didn't want to know what perm means. He says 76 the car sorry, number 67 is overtaking that car. I'm not sure that is a problem. But 18 gets a warning for 18 gets a final warning for contact, possible bump drafting, or just side-to-side contact there. Bump drafting is not the best idea in some of these cars, especially with the Suzuki open wheel car, and they have pointy noses basically. Actually, it is not permitted in the released NASCAR rules and regulations, which you can also find at the LFS forum under the realist NASCAR sub section that leads. And the lead battle has now gone down to 3 cars, which is I will give you the name in a minute. The front, the top three are not in order. Sammy is in number 69 car. Corny is in the number 52, and Martin Capel is in the number 64. They are in a drafting battle at the moment. As I said before, it's all about getting a rim in the drafting. Can't get a rim, you won't go as fast as most people. I just got an email from Starbucks if you wanted to know. Also, there's a battle for... Give me a second. There's a battle for fifth. Between 1, 2... Actually, they're all over the place, I don't know who's who. So, there's a few battles going on, a few involving lap cars, unfortunately. This is the battle here. I think our camera guy has got it now. Yes, this is the battle I'm talking about. This is now a 4-car battle between 74, 18, 67, and 96. The own number 16 seems to have a bit of damage to his rear wing, which will affect the downforce as well as the draft of his. This pack here. The draft in LFS is not the best mod. You can get it for far distance, which is quite an unrealistic distance at some points. But it is an advantage to the league, obviously. It's all about the rhythm and making sure. Ooh, there was a lagging car there. Not sure who that was. It was in the wall. So, with 31 laps remaining, I will go through the top 5 as they were at the line. In first was Martin Capel in the number 64 car. Sammy Hovian, again, sorry for the pronunciation of these names, in the number 69 is second. In third is Thomas Kearney in the 52 car. In fourth is Ramon Blauer in the number 58. And number 18 is fifth Mark from Scuderia AGP. We've now gone down to sixth. Sorry, that was the change in order. Sorry. Oh, we got a crash on. Oh, sorry, I didn't. I'm looking. There's a few cars off, there's one car in the grass. He comes up, oh, he gets collected! threw me straight up back on the track and he collected by, I think, the number 26 car, but he, 26 continues 50. Major damage to the front nose cone of that car. Lucky to get out of that one because he did heavily, he was hit heavy. In the rear right hand side of the car. But the green flag stays out with 29 laps remaining. But we seem like we had someone in the wall. I'm sorry, there's just a little bit of lag on some of the cars. The top but the top three continue to battle it out, as well as, well, 58 Ramon Blauhoff is still he's trying to catch the top three, but it's quite hard without a draft, someone to draft with anyway, and he is falling into the battle for fifth position, which he seemed to die down a bit, but he's still quite close racing there. I'd just like to say, if you would join us for the third annual Kyoto 400 here at the Kyoto Ring in February. And we'll just get the date for you now. On the 17th, we'll be racing in the XRR at this circuit. So if you join us then, we will have a full qualifying report before the start of the race. You can find it here at simrace.tv on stream number 1. The stream will start at, when I find the right place, the stream will start at 16:40 GMT, hopefully. If you join us for that, we'll hopefully have more than one commentator at a time. Hopefully get some better guys than me as well. I've been asking around for some commentators, and if you are watching and you would like to help commentate, please send me a PM on the Love for Speed forum. My username is Jonathan.Provost. You'll see it in the Real International section someplace. And Remco Major, he just pointed out to Race Control that there are lap cars ahead. I don't think he'll do anything about that, to be honest, but if they are holding up, the lap cars may get a penalty. Remco slightly hits one of the lap cars, the number 7 car. As to say, get out our way. Clayton, putting it. It is also a battle. Oh, sorry, I'm split. The leaders are mixed up with a few backrunners now. Will be in a minute. Got one backrunner, the number 45, but he is holding off and going to the inside. Thank you. Yeah, the leaders are now clear of lap traffic for the moment. One of the problems on ovals, you do get a lot of lap traffic, obviously. It can be a pain at some time that you're racing. I think Blauhoff is falling more and more back due to the fact that the battle for fifth is battle for fifth has draft. So they are catching up a lot quicker. Blauhoff is almost now going to be in the battle for, which is now fourth, between the number 58 of Blauhoff, the number 69 of Campus, and who else? And the number 18 of Burns. Again, sorry for the pronunciation, I never get names right, so sorry for that. The Blauhoff now firmly in that battle. Trying to keep one, something is under view. Oh, and we have a car turning in turn 3. He is the wrong way round, he's in the wall. Hopefully he can get down to the apron without getting contact. He does. He stays on the track and, oh, he spins again. A gap may go to the apron. It seems that his tyres are extremely warm now. I think is obviously the problem. He goes into the pit lane and he's number 69, he's lagging quite a lot at the moment, but he can sack on the connection. So we'll see if we can get any battles. The battle now for fourth is only between Blauhoff and Trumpus. At the moment, Burns is now in the battle for 5th place, I think. Yes, he is in two other cars, I think. Oh no, sorry, there are lap cars. No, they're not. There's one lap car. Sorry, I'm all over the place. I don't know who's who at the minute. So. Give me a minute. We have 14 laps remaining now. So not long to go. Hopefully this can all be green flag racing, but hopefully that wasn't the commentator's curse. We still have quite a few battles going on. And the 26 is back on the apron. He'd have gone through the pit lane and changed tyres. Or changed tyres and something gone wrong. He's back in the pit lane for the second time in 2 laps, so not sure what's going on there, but we will investigate. So you're speaking to Ray Control there. An incident involving car 14 and a lapped car. Won't tell everyone's point of view. People have their decisions at the minute. I'll leave that up to them. I'm only commentating at the minute. So, the battle for first of you, they are hitting traffic now. Hopefully they can get past without incident. The battle for fourth is also hitting a bit of traffic. That's between Frontpress and Blauhoff. Don't seem to be any of battles. Actually, yes, there is a battle. Seems to be for 8th, I think. It's hard to tell when he loads a lap car over the place. The lead is now getting through the traffic. Getting split up through traffic is one of the worst things that could happen in an over race. If you get a split up from a draft, you won't get it. It's very hard to get it back on your own. But a lapped car, I'm not sure what number it is, keep going past. It's like 14, he's sticking to the back of that pack. Probably just trying to get a advantage from the draft. The 11 rejoined the track after, I think, going into the pit lane. There in the pack, just getting a bit wobbly. Looks like his tyres are wearing and are quite hot at the moment. Even I'm at a pool of North Devon, is key here, especially in the government V8. To mention, I'm not sure if Walter Lemmings did, but R2 and R3 tyres are the only tyres allowed to be used in the event today. All four tyres have to be the same compound. You can't have frontage R2 and rear R3. They all have to be the same compound. And 69. Oh, sorry, we just a bit of lag. 69 seems to be lagging quite a bit now. A lot, actually. That could be a problem, especially as he is in a battle with the other two leaders. That could change feeling slightly, shall we say. The 43 pulls over for the leaders. He is 5 laps down, according to the tracker, which might not be wrong. That might not be right, sorry. 4 laps remaining, not long to go. Last laps, it's all about strategic. Planning, basically, there's a better word. Planning the draft. All about the draft on the final corner and how close you are. can win from third, basically. Yeah, especially if you've got a pack like this. On the last lap, you're about knowing when to hold off and when to put the power down. Is the main thing. Three laps, you mean? I don't think the traffic down is right. Change that. Okay, that'll sort it. Oh, under your car! Sorry, I missed that. There was your car spun on the front straight, that was the number 7 car. He is now continuing. But the battle for first still continues. There are a few more battles on the track, but most of them involve lap cars. You cannot probably get it wrong. Still, we have. We're almost on the final lap. We are now on, well, now on the final lap. All about making sure that you're in the right position at the right time at the on the last corner. Get the draft, the correct draft. We stick with the leaders to see if this should be a tight finish, just like the previous two We go into the final corner and Capel and Silver into the wall. That leaves Corny on his own to win the race by 0.68 seconds. He wasn't really finished, but that's racing. We'll go through the results on the tracker when it decides to behave. Everyone now returning to the pit lane, and Corny going, I think, to the finish line for his celebrations. And that's everyone across the line, so I'll have to put the check flag on the tracker. Wait for that to reload. The winner is confirmed as Corny with a 0.68 second lead. He is now on the start finish straight and now doing donuts. So, a very big congratulations to Corny. I will go through the results in a moment. I'd like to say a big thank you to JSRK for doing the camera choice today on the stream. It's not easy doing it, you know. It's quite hard thinking where the commentator is actually looking. So a big thank you to him for helping the stream today. At the winning car of the day. I shall remove the tracker for you. Actually, I'll leave that up for now, so we can go through it. So, in first is Thomas Cunney in the 52 car. Second is the 64 of Martin Capel. Third is the number 69 of Sammy. Again, I'm sorry, I'm not going to pronounce your last name because I'll probably get it wrong. In fourth is Ronnie Compass in the number 96. Raymond Blauhoff gets the fifth position in the number 58. Sixth is Mark Burnend in the 18. Seventh is 14, Remco Majeure. Eighth is number 67, Sebastian. Ninth is number 04. Yes, ninth is number 04, another Sebastian. Tenth is number 50, Holmberg. I'll go for the top 15 because this could take a while. 11th is number 07, Rafael. 12th is number 32, Patrick Hall. 13th is number 53, Anglov. 14th is number 29, Silva. And 15th is number 74. Again, sorry for my mispronouncing your names. I'd like to say a very well done to all of the drivers today. Quite a few retirements though, unfortunately, due to incidents and race, well, some race which I will turn that on. We don't need all these titles. So that was the third annual Realistic NASCAR IndyCar 250. 250 miles were completed. They were very well done to all of the drivers, which I just said that, and I'm repeating myself, and I don't like doing that, so I'm sorry. I'd say a big thank you to the Realistic NASCAR staff for doing yet again another brilliant job. In race control, it's not the easiest job in the world, but someone's got to do it, and they did it very well today. Could have gone a bit smoother with some of the incidents at the beginning, but after we got a few less cars, it sort of settled down and battles started beginning. The battle at the finish was looking to be tight, but unfortunately that contact between Martin Capel and Sammy Hovinen resulted in them slowing down and basically giving the to me. He did well get it, and yeah, he did well to get it. Running out of things to say at the moment. So, join us next month on the 17th of February for the Kyoto 400. We are streaming live on stream 1 of simrace.tv. Hopefully we'll have some more decent commentators than me, but hopefully we'll have another tracker code so we can not have the thing at this whole time. Yeah, we do have our Facebook page now, search in Facebook Realistic NASCAR, and you should please like us there. Next week we will be answering questions on the stream from there. Not next week again, it's next month, on the 17th. I keep doing that, sorry. So you can drop us a line there, ask you any questions, we'll be glad to help. If you would like to volunteer to be a commentator next month, at that time, for the Kyoto 500, please PM me on the Live for Speed forum. My username is jonathan.prevost. You can find my username anywhere in the NASCAR sub forum and thread. It should be there. Please, if you have any questions for the next round, drop a line on Facebook or my PM box, and I will hopefully answer them soonish. I'd like to say again, big thank you to everyone for joining us and viewing the stream. You can watch this on demand on YouTube and raisemedia.org. A big thanks to Lutz, who is the person who sorts out the streams for simrace.tv. He always puts them on the simmedia.org and their YouTube. I will link, well, Cameron Collins will link to the track of results as well as the stream on demand link. So, after me blabbering for a bit, thank you for joining us, and we'll see you next time.